Today we celebrate 1st of May, which is also known as the International Workers' Day. And if you look on Wikipedia, it's also described as Labor Day or May Day. It's a celebration of laborers and the working classes that is promoted by the international labor movement, which occurs every year on May Day, an ancient European spring festival. Isn't that wonderful? And they don't mention communism at all, because it's the communists that created the event and promoted International Workers' Day. Now, I want to be absolutely clear that I do not believe in the genetic fallacy. Just because something comes from bad people doesn't make the thing necessarily bad. I mean, it's a day where people get off work and they get to do whatever they want. Who doesn't like a day that is free? Everyone likes a day that is free. Except today in 2020 when the pandemic is about and there's stay-at-home orders. And if you tell someone, it's like, oh, happy International Workers' Day. They're like, oh, God, I've been out of a job for 2 months. I just want to go out and work. I'm going to starve to death. I hope my government give me some handouts so I don't die. But what's really peculiar about May Day compared to other celebrations like, I don't know, Thanksgiving or 4th of July is that most people learn in schools why 4th of July is being celebrated or where does Thanksgiving come from. There's articles written in the press and on the television it's being heavily covered. But when it comes to May Day, almost no one knows about its origin. Where does it come from? When did it start being celebrated? It's almost the same like Women's Day, isn't it? So it's going to be up to me, this little squeaky voice on the YouTube, in order to explain to you the origins of the holiday. Now, our story begins in the United States after the, what historians like to call the Long Depression. And after every depression, you get a period of economic prosperity, where we notice rapid expansion of industrial production in the United States. And wherever there is rapid expansion of industrial production, there needs to be cheap labor. And this cheap labor is being brought in from Europe. We notice tens of thousands of German and Bohemian immigrants being brought in and paid quite poorly, even for at the time, $1.50 a day was barely enough to survive from month to month. But the problem is that when you bring tens of thousands of immigrants, you also bring in their culture. And in this case, because they brought in German immigrants, they also brought in socialism. So we now start to notice an open friction between the employers, the factory owners, and the immigrants. The employers are responding with anti-union measures, such as firing and blacklisting union members, locking out workers, recruiting strike breakers, employing spies, thugs, and private security forces, and also exacerbating ethnic tensions in order to divide the workers. In other words, nothing really changed from back then till today, now has it? Now, the workers, they are concentrating their ideology around a German language newspaper, one Arbeit Zeitung. It's translated in English as the Worker Times. And they are promoting revolutionary ideology. They are promoting so that the workers become an armed militia that is going to be equipped with guns and explosives. So the strategy of their revolution was centered around the belief that successful operations against the police and the seizure of major industrial centers would result in massive public support for the workers and thus start a revolution that would destroy capitalism and establish a socialist economy. Notice how they're not actually pushing for hate speech though? Like with all that, they're still not violating Twitter's TOS? Isn't that fascinating, isn't it? Now, I want to make it absolutely clear that I do believe the workers at that time did have some legitimate grievances. It's not a black and white issue. Most of the factory owners would also work hand in hand with the mafia that would also extort the workers, that would beat up workers. And if you are to have a worker that, let's say, suffers a work accident simply because the employer didn't take the necessary precautions, well, that person would just be fired. They would not get any sort of days off. They would not get any sort of benefits. And for someone who comes from Germany on a boat trip, which would take a couple of days to complete, you could see how desperate these people were. And this desperation is going to be channeled by the left-leaning ideologues in order to get political clout and to push their agenda. And we notice that this is exactly what happens at the Haymarket incident. And this takes place on May the 4th, 1886, at Haymarket Square in Chicago. And it begins as a peaceful rally in support of the workers, which are asking for an 8-hour workday. And they're starting a strike. They basically refuse to go back to their factories unless their demands are met. So eventually the police arrives, and the things are still going calmly about it. The workers are still peaceful striking. They're just moving around the town protesting. When someone from the crowd of the workers throws a dynamite at the police officers. Now, when judging a historical event, it's very important that we judge it from the lens of that particular time period, which is 1886. Back then, police officers didn't have water cannons, they didn't have pepper sprays. What they did have was live ammunition. So when some event like this happens, when someone throws a Molotov cocktail into the police or someone throws a dynamite, the police will simply just open fire on the workers. And this resulted with massive numbers of arrests, over 100, over 70 people from the workers being injured, and 4 workers being killed. So let's recap what happened. The workers are exercising their First Amendment right by going around town and protesting the working conditions. The police are there and there is no incident. And at one point, a filthy communist from the workers, who I guess believes in accelerationism, throws a soy bomb at the cops and the cops open fire. Do you see why I do not like communists? Because they always put their ideology ahead of even the people they claim they protect. They claim they stand up for the workers, but I guess you can't make an omelet without breaking a few eggs. Even if the eggs you're breaking are little workers that are being shot now because you threw the soy bomb. And somehow I need to look at this event and view how the communists are the good guys. Now, how do we know that they were communists? Well, apparently there was a trial. And while they didn't manage to find the actual person who threw the soy bomb, because the prime suspect managed to flee the country and took refuge in London, they did manage to arrest the conspirators, many of whom were actually hanged. And what I like about Wikipedia is that they all are called anarchists. Like, for example, Clemens Schutz was identified as the bomber by Franz Mayhoff, a New York anarchist and fraudster. As if these people were anarcho-capitalists. As if these people were anything but blatant communists. But, you know, you'll notice that communism always does this in history. Whenever communism does something bad, if it's possible, they will use code names like codename anarchist, rather than just say, yes, blatant communist agitator Clemens Schutz was responsible for the Haymarket affair. They just leave it as a small footnote in the page of history. And this is legitimately why you will never hear the history of why we celebrate 1st of May. They don't talk about it on television. They don't teach it in schools. They don't teach it in the mainstream media because it makes communists look awful. Would workers have managed to improve their working conditions without the quote-unquote help from the anarchists? The answer is absolutely yes. We noticed that in other countries where anarchists didn't pose such a major force, workers managed to get rights without being shot by the cops at the agitation of revolutionaries. And I find absolutely hilarious that other holidays such as Columbus Day or Thanksgiving can come under scrutiny because of their origin, but you will never find actual communist holidays such as 1st of May come under any scrutiny whatsoever. Now, as we go to Wikipedia, we can say that the date of 1st of May was chosen by a pan-national organization of socialist and communist political parties to commemorate the Haymarket Affair, which occurred in Chicago on 4th of May, 1886. The 1946 conference of the Second International called on all socialist democratic party organizations and trade unions of all countries to demonstrate energetically on the 1st of May for the legal establishment of the 8-hour workday for the class demands of the proletariat and the universal peace. The 1st of May is a national public holiday in many countries across the world, and in most cases Labor Day or the International Workers' Day or similar name, although some countries celebrate Labor Day on dates significant to them, such as the United States and Canada, which celebrate Labor Day on the first Monday of September. So now you know, and knowing is half the battle. Again, I don't have anything against a day where people get to stay at home and relax. But I do think it's important for people to understand the history and to understand what brought up the events of this particular holiday. Because in a way, I'm really sick and tired every time people celebrate 4th of July or Thanksgiving or any other American holiday, they start looking at the origin and they go, wow, well, you know, bad things happened. Should we really celebrate this? But whenever it's a communist holiday, like 1st of May, people don't even know the origins. They don't even discuss it. It's like, is it really something that we should celebrate? And my answer is yes. Yes, you should. I mean, I don't mind, you know, the reason for the celebration as long as there's a celebration. So that would be my answer regarding it. Let me know in the comment section what you think. If you didn't know about the events or you have any extra questions, feel free to ask me. And I hope you really enjoyed this video. Please share it around if you found it to your liking. And I'll see you all on my secondary channel. The link is into the pinned comment.